Welcome back to The Pulse. And the nuclear clock is ticking faster for Israel than for US. And we'll stop Tehran alone if we have to. That is the warning from Israeli Defense Minister Ehud Barak. He says his government is ultimately responsible for, quote, crucial security issues.
There is no place to close our eyes. While you are sleeping, you feel the sword in your throat. You try to continue sleeping quietly, but you cannot sleep quietly when the Iranians are systematically moving forward to a point where Israel will not be able to do anything about it.
We're going to cross live to Tel Aviv now to speak to Emily Landau. She heads the Arms Control and Regional Security Project at Israel's Institute for National Security Studies. Welcome to The Pulse, Emily. And are you concerned about this rhetoric from Israel, the emphasizing that it could take unilateral action, indeed military? Do you think military force is likely?
Well, I think right now we are in the midst of the diplomatic process. We're in the midst of negotiations. The international community is in the midst of negotiations. There have been two rounds in Istanbul and Baghdad. There will be another round in mid-June. And as long as the negotiations are ongoing, I would not expect any military action. I think the way to understand these statements that were issued by Defense Minister Ehud Barak is that Israel is watching these negotiations closely. It has seen that two rounds have ended with nothing more concrete than a decision on the next round. The expectations were that there would be concrete decisions made, concrete agreements with Iran in the nuclear realm. That has not happened. And I think Israel is trying to make it clear that something needs to be achieved in these negotiations. Israel is watching from the sidelines, is nervous, and is very clear about the fact that a nuclear Iran is the worst outcome of this overall dynamic.
So, Emily, what could the West, we have the UN Security Council plus Germany negotiating with Iran, what can they offer, what can they threaten to Iran to resolve the nuclear crisis? Because at the moment, sanctions just aren't proving enough.
Well, that's the most important question in this dynamic. And obviously, when you look at the structure of this negotiation, the P5 plus one are at a disadvantage because they are dependent on a negotiated settlement in order to achieve their goal of Iran stopping its march to the bomb, whereas Iran has no need for this negotiation in order to reach its goal, which is to attain a military capability. So the West needs some clout in order to change Iran's calculation, and that's the role of pressure. Very good sanctions have been put in place, biting sanctions, crippling sanctions, but right now Iran is testing the resolve of the P5 plus one.
Emily.
And it might be that...
Emily Landau, Director of the Arms Control and Regional Security, thank you for your time.